I extend a welcome to our dear students. Step out into the world. Remember that the knowledge and values you have acquired here will guide you in your future commencement. We are extremely proud of each of you and excited to see the great things you will accomplish. I extend welcome to the parents. Your unwavering support and encouragement have been the bedrock of your children's success. Your belief in their potential and of our institution have been a cornerstone of their journey. Today, we celebrate not just the achievements of our students, but also the sacrifices and dedication of their families. Thank you for being there as a guiding light. I would like to leave you all with a quote by Nelson Mandela. Education is the most powerful weapon which you can use to change the world. As you move forward, may you use your education to make a positive impact and create a better future for all of us. Once again, I welcome all of you to this joyous celebration. Thank you.
Is also the founder of Cricket, our NGO supported by the Indian Entrepreneur Ecosystem. A founding trustee of MOVE, dedicated towards uplifting and empowering women across the globe. Governing Council member of HKBK Group of Institutions, imparting world-class technical and management education in India. And Governing Council member of Mohammed Ishaq University College. Sabina Sultana was also a spokesperson for the National Congress Party and also the state vice president of All India Professional Congress. Before she was conferred with an honorary council position by Tunisian government in recognition for her efforts and contribution in various aspects of social responsibilities as a business person. We are highly pleased to have you, Mom, among us. Thank you.
I take the great pleasure to welcome Ms. Shabina Sultana to enlighten the program with your golden words and inspiring thoughts. Over to you, Mom.
Good afternoon, my dear students. I didn't see much of happiness on your faces. Your exam is coming up, and today is the day you're celebrating your achievements. I can see only few smiling faces. Come on, cheer up, it's your day and it's a proud day for you all to celebrate.
So you take the candid video, sir.
And here I am to congratulate you. It's my honor and privilege to be on this podium today in this esteemed institution. Thank you so much for having me.
Shakti.
Let me just
Master
talk
shot.
About
Master shot.
Who I am. Yes, there was an introduction, but that's not relatively you, and I would want to represent myself as the Honorary Council of Tunisia. Anybody here aware of where Tunisia is? Great, all the more that I need to share with you where Tunisia is, okay. So this is a North African country, and it is very strategically located. I've been given the charge of being the representative of Tunisia in India, especially south of India, and my role and objective would be in promoting the trade and commerce. We take opportunities like these to create more awareness, to spread the word and educate about the country that we represent as the Honorary Council. In the introductory note, they did say that I was so and so, but I would love to be a student. I would love to be a learner throughout my life, because education is something which is very, very precious, and it just grows, and your skills have to be developed as you graduating from esteemed university and institution like this. And what I would want to say is, this is just the beginning. I'm sure you've climbed the mountains, you felt the pain. Why we climb the mountains and the achievement of the view that you get from top of the mountain is something marvelous. And I think you are all standing there encapsulating the entire beauty of your career way forward. And there's recognized good institutions like this, where you are very lucky to get all the support from not only your parents, but from the faculty members, from the resources they provide you, from the entire management and the... Having said that, I hope I'm not boring you all too much, but another small thing I would definitely want to tell you all is, do not hesitate to take risks, because as management students, you would be procrastinating as to, is this the way or is that the way? But my dear students, risk, but calculated risk, is something which every individual should take in today's perspective. Because the world is competing, I mean, the competition is enormous. And with the amount of knowledge you all have gained through the internet, through AI, and beyond that, it's like, what is that you would want to take and what is that you would want to leave? So I think calculated risk is something which everybody should indulge in, because even if you win, you would be the winner after taking the risk. But if you lose, you still have the experience. And that experience is going to live with you throughout your life.
Dear teachers, principals, HODs, and my esteemed students, it's indeed a great day for you. You have achieved something great in your life with your hard work, perseverance, and so much of effort being put to get this graduation today. I see a huge crowd of about 600 to 700 students waiting to get the graduation. And this is not the end of your life. You need to achieve a lot of things in your life from now on. Learning is a continuous process. You need to understand that there is no limit for it. Today's world is so competitive. Today's world is so competitive that you have to, as Madam said, you have to put in some efforts and risk in your life to achieve what you need. Risks are a must. Without taking risks, I don't think management students, you can reach to what you want and what you expect. Lot of companies are there, lot of students have been placed in different companies based on their skills. But some students are not placed in the requirement what is expected of. But still, don't lose hope, because you need still to go further. You have got a post-graduation, you have got the graduation. A lot of startups have come up. You can put in your efforts and start up your own business. So many things which the government has also provided these days for you to come up in your life. So dear students, this is not a good thing. You need to still do this further and see that you reach greater heights. That's one story which I would like to share as a simple person with my father, whom I would dedicate his entire institution to him. To start off, I remember my father who came here at the age of 17 years into Bangalore and was working as an employee in the telecom industry. His only aim was to give me good education. For this education, he had to struggle. You can understand what if the job a 10th standard student can do. So he got a job in ITI and he was looking after our family. And I was the eldest son. We were in fact staying in a kachcha house, to tell you fine. 7 years it took me to get into a pakka house. And that's where my brother was born. And from there, he used to work so hard in life. He started learning electrical work, he went and did electrician work, and wanted me to somehow, and his aim was only to make me a doctor. And I used to see his struggle so hard in life. I used to really feel that I need to achieve certain things in my life, at least to keep him happy. For him, education was the only thing which we couldn't afford, in fact, even those days. It was very tough to get into a professional college. I somehow managed to get in merit, and I got into a college where I hardly need to spend about 5,000 rupees a year. But that itself was so difficult for my father to achieve. But he was such a visionary, he tried to learn so many things looking at people. He went into so many businesses, and finally he achieved. And the only thing what he told me was that, see that every... And today I miss him, because all these 18 years of his struggle, he only wanted his student to achieve. And he wanted that to be part of the student. We do train so many students these days. We do give so many free education to students in different operators and schools. These are all things because it was his plan. And this plan is being carried by me. And today I'm so proud. His vision was that we need to have at least 1,000 students in this campus. Today we have got more than 5,000 students in this campus. And we have come up with so many programs. And I hope that this continues. And you see, so happy that at the graduation ceremony, 600 to 700 students a year coming out of. Actually, we have 1,000 students coming out of the year. Today I can see at least over 400-500 students here coming for graduation. I think it's a proud achievement on the part of Koshi Group of Institution. We have chosen a good institute. I think we have given our best, whatever is possible from our side. I need you to reach heights, to reach to the extent that where you will be a good alumni for us, and we will be all eagerly waiting for you to come back and serve this institution. And I wish you all the very good luck. Thank you.
Today marks a momentous occasion, celebrating the culmination of our hard work and dedication. We gather here not only to commemorate our graduation, but also to honor the outstanding achievements of our top performers who have excelled in their academic journey. Today we are honored to have Ms. Kasimetti. The life you influence and the positive change you bring to the world. May your accomplishments continue to inspire you to reach greater heights and remain beacons of excellence in all your endeavors. Call our leader, Ms. Sandhya S., Principal of Kushit Institute of Management Studies, for oath-taking.
I request all of you to stand for the oath-taking ceremony. Please stretch your right hand towards front and I request you to repeat whatever I say after me. Creation of the opportunities afforded to me by Kushit Institute of Management Studies. I hereby pledge to dedicate myself to the continuing search for truth and knowledge, to strive for the improvement of the common man, to discipline my will, so as to elevate and preserve high moral and spiritual life, all for the service of my country, humanity, and God. Thank you all. I request to kindly take.
Good afternoon, distinguished Chief Guest, Ms. Shabina Sultana, Honorary Consul for the Republic of Tunisia, Guest of Honor, Dr. Sandhya Shosh, Chairman, Kushit Group of Institutions, Special Guest, Dr. Sarina Shaji, Dean, Kushit Group of Institutions, other dignitaries on the dais and off the dais, various head of the departments, teaching fraternity and non-teaching staff, students and their parents. It's a great privilege and pleasure to deliver a vote of thanks on this special occasion. First and foremost, I would like to express the heartfelt thanks to our chief guest for the day, Ms. Shabana Sultana, Honorary Consul for the Republic of Tunisia, for taking time out of her busy schedule to grace this memorable occasion. Thank you, madam. I take this opportunity to thank the guest of honor, Dr. Sandhya Shoshi, Chairman, KGI, for being the driving force of our organization. Thank you, sir. I would like to thank our special guest, Dr. Sarina Shaji, Dean, KGI, for her unwavering support and encouragement. Thank you, ma'am. My sincere thanks to Dr. Prakash T. Naik, Director, Academic Schemes, for his valuable contribution. I thank you, sir. I thank Dr. Sara Kunnath, Academic Advisor Kings, for her continued support and dedication. Thank you, ma'am. My heartfelt gratitude to Dr. Sandhya Yes, Principal Kings, for being a true leader and guiding us in organizing this event. Thank you, ma'am. I would like to thank all the vice principals of various institutions under TGI, all the head of the departments, for working tirelessly towards the success of this event. My sincere thanks to the teaching fraternity for their continuous support extended in putting up a special event like this. I would also like to thank the non-teaching staff, the NCC team, for all that has extended. I owe a special gratitude to the facility department who have worked hard to ensure the success of this event. Thank you all. I thank all the proud parents who have come here to be with us and witness their wards graduating today. And finally, hearty congratulations and a big thanks to all dear graduating students for making this day truly special and memorable. As we walk out of the portals of this institution, I would like to call Henry David Scott, go confidently in the direction of your dream, lead the life you have imagined. Happy learning, continue learning.